Welcome to an example of the counting principle and probability using the counting principle. We're given that three boys and three girls stand in line. The first question is, in how many ways can they line up? One way to answer this question is to use the counting principle, where we think of this as a series of events, determine the number of ways each event can occur, and then find the product of these numbers of ways. And since there are six people lining up, we'll think of this as six different events. And we'll start by determining the number of ways we can select someone for the first position. Well, since there are six people, there are six ways to select the person for the first position. And then for the second position, since there's five people left, there are five ways to determine the second position. For the third position, there are four people left, so there are four ways to select someone for this position, followed by three ways to select the fourth position. There are two people left, so there are two ways to select someone for the fifth position, followed by one person left, so there's one way to select someone for the sixth position. So this product would give us the number of ways the six people can line up, which would be 6 factorial, which is equal to 720. We can also think of this as a permutation, since the order matters. 6 permute 6 would also be equal to 720. For part B, we're asked in how many ways can they line up if the first person in line is a boy, and then the line alternates by gender. So we still have six positions to fill in line, but now we're told that the first position must be a boy. And then from here, the gender is going to alternate, so it'll go boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl. And since the first position has to be a boy, there's only three boys to select from, so there are three ways to select someone for the first position. There are only three girls, so there's only three ways to select the second position. The third position must be a boy. There's only two boys remaining because one boy is in the first position, so there are two ways to select the third position. The fourth position must be a girl. There are two girls remaining, so there are two ways to select a girl for the fourth position. There's only one boy remaining now because there's a boy in position 1 and 3. So there's only one way to select a boy for the fifth position and one way to select a girl for the last position. So this product will be the number of ways in which a boy is first and then the gender alternates. Well, 3 times 3 times 2 times 2 times 1 times 1 would just be 9 times 4 or 36. So there are 36 ways this can occur. The last two questions deal with probability. Probability is equal to the number of favorable ways divided by the total number of ways an event can occur. So for part C, we want to find the probability that the first person in line is a boy and the line alternates by gender. We can actually find this probability using the answers from A and B. The favorable number of ways that we can have boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, we already found from part B that can occur 36 ways. And then the total number of ways that they can line up is from part A, which is 720 ways. So this is the probability expressed as a fraction. Let's go ahead and simplify this. These are both divisible by 36. As a simplified fraction, the probability would be 1/20. But probability can also be expressed as a decimal or a percentage. Let's go ahead and convert this to a decimal. So we'd have 1 divided by 20, which you probably recognize as 0.5. So we can say this is equal to 0.05. Or as a percentage, we would multiply by 100 and add a percent symbol. So this would be 5%. So these three values are equivalent to express our probability of having the first person in line be a boy and then alternating by gender. Now for the last question, we want to find the probability that the gender alternates in line, meaning we can have a boy first or a girl first, but then the gender must alternate. So we can have boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, or girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, boy. Well, we already know the favorable number of ways of having a boy first and then alternating by gender is 36 from part C or part B. But notice how if we had girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, The number of ways this can occur would also be 36. So we'll have to add another 36 favorable ways divided by the total number of ways, which is still 720. So now our probability is 72 divided by 720, which simplifies nicely to 1/10. Notice how the probability is double the probability of having a boy first and then alternating gender. So as a decimal, this would be 0.1. As a percent, this would be 10%. Okay, that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.